Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. He's banging his head around. We got a party of six now. With Marcus, Vic, Sulik, Andrea King, main character, Goris, and Robo Brain, or Brain Bot, depending on who you talk to. So we're here at the Abbey, which there's a monastery and a small community built around it. We are here for, well, we need to inform Brother Samuel and Father Tulley about the whereabouts of each other. Am I supposed to get some kind of hooch here or something? Bring a bottle of Abbey's hooch to Father Tulley back in New Reno. Killed a bunch of mobsters over in New Reno. You know, I'm curious. And now we've got magnetic personality. More than five is always a crowd. I don't know if that includes me or not, or they mean more than five companions. And now there's six of us. So our karma for. Yeah, married. I'm a widow already. Made man of the right family, you're well known, respected, look great in the fedora. I had no idea that would show up. Champion. Norina was liked. I lost some karma. We're idolized in a lot of places. Alright, so I already have my gun away. I'm just gonna bet that our companion's gonna have their guns as is. If not, we should get a warning. Hey, get away from my car, peasant. Yeah, I know, it's pretty boring here, but at least we're safe from raiders and such. I wasn't talking about that. A stump. Nothing really exciting. In fact, this might be the least exciting thing you've ever laid your eyes on. I think that would be rocks. Before I even mess around with the Abbey, let's check out these buildings, these outlying buildings. This community. What's this? Oh, it's just some junk. I already have some junk. Have you seen my invisible friend? No? Probably because it's invisible. Who is cutting a muffin? Greetings. Trader Bill. What do you have to offer, Trader Bill? Hello there, traveler. Name's Bill. What can I get for you? Say, I've noticed a lot of old equipment and items have been collected here at the Abbey. I don't suppose you found anything special during your time here? Heh, so you noticed that, huh? Yeah, the Abbey folks have a bit of a fascination with anything pre-war, especially if it's tech-related. They form some kind of kooky religion around it. I don't quite understand it myself, but they're nice people and they pay good money for anything pre-war I managed to get my hands on. But anyway, as for something special, he glances over at Marcus. It's funny you should ask. I just might have something that would interest your friend here. Such as? You see, a caravan came through here not too long ago, claiming to have come up from the deep south, said they'd been attacked by some of them vile mutants. He turns to Marcus. No offense, big guy. Anyway, they did a lot of bragging about how they wasted all the muties, claimed there'd been nearly a dozen of them, and I call bullshit. But it turns out they had some proof. Yeah? What was that? Incidentally, before I continue, the idolizing and forming a religion about a pre-war tech stuff reminds me a lot about Mad Max, specifically Beyond Thunderdome, I'm guessing, right? So proof, yeah, what was that? A hulking set of mutant armor they'd managed to salvage off one of the corpses. Of course, for all I know, they'd stole it off the bones of some long-dead mutie they stumbled upon in the waste, but who knows? Mutant armor. Cool. That's good, because we just found out last episode when we enlisted Marcus that he can't wear armor because they don't make it his size. Where are we, guys? Anyway, they weren't eager to keep lugging the heavy thing around, so they offered it to me for dirt cheap. I didn't know what I'd ever do with it, but I figured a deal's a deal. Well, I'm sure Marcus here could benefit from this. How much for it? Well, this bad boy could easily be melted down to make 3 or 4 sets of metal armor. Let's say 3,000. Alright, I've got enough for that. Alright, this is going to take 2 of us to move this thing, so let me help you fit it to your friend here. Well, we only need 1 set of armor. I'm not paying for all of them, am I? Do I have this in my inventory? Or does he automatically have it on? Looks like he has it on. Marcus!
What do you want? Yeah? What? Yeah? What?
I want to take a look at what the armor he's wearing. I need you to remove the armor that you're wearing.
Right.
Did it actually change his portrait? Hold on. Take it easy, don't bash yourself too much.
What do you want?
Trade. That's what I want. Mutant armor. If I take it, I can't carry that much. Oh, it's 100 pounds. I want a description of it. $170. Okay, if I just temporarily give him 20 pounds, I can carry that and look at it.
What do you want?
That's right, we can see the pounds here. 7. That's 11. Okay. Geiger counter and 223. There we go. So you can keep that. I want a description of the mutant armor. And you can most easily find descriptions of things in your own inventory. Nope, mutant armor weighs 100 pounds, that's all we got.
What do you want?
Alright. It's pretty interesting looking. Just in the inventory, I gotta say.
Yeah? What? I'm all set.
No, it didn't change him. For some reason I thought it did. Alright, that's pretty awesome.
What do you want?
So now that he's wearing that... Okay. So, now we got Super Marcus Super Mutant. Pretty sweet. I'm glad it was only 3,000. I thought it was going to be like 15,000 bucks or some crap. Alright, let's see if this guy has anything else interesting to sell. Let's barter. It doesn't have too much. Leather armor. I guess you could come here much earlier than this. You know, instead of... Hold on. Who's got the interesting stuff here?
What you be needing?
He definitely doesn't have enough for that. Good. Sulik doesn't have anything to give us. The cooler report. Mm. So I wonder if we're gonna need that technical manual for anything. Seems like a quest item. Yeah. Vic's good, it's just our robot and probably Goris. Who are where? Huh. Exactly, here's Goris. Just take this stuff. That's gonna be more than enough. Cause the guy does have $300, and he's got some. He's got like a stim pack and some healing powder. It's got some pretty useless stuff. Sad to say. Oh, 184. Yeah, we can't do that. Can't do that either. I might just take the hit on this, because I like to get rid of that ammo. Yeah, close enough. See ya. Don't lock me in here. Alright, here, take the stuff back. I want to be free to pick up whatever I want. Alright, so... Oh, we've got some... Brahmin over here. Junkyard wannabe. There's a crate. Greetings, Mrs. Peterson. Talk to my husband if you need something, okay? A young, strong-looking man. Is that Mr. Peterson? Hello, friend. Haven't seen you around here before. First time to the Abbey? Why am I asking about the GAC? Yeah, what can you tell me about this place? The wife and I came here a few years ago in a caravan. We liked it here so much we decided to stay and start our own little farm. Let me tell you, the Abbey might not be as flashy as New Reno or advanced as Vault City, but as far as I'm concerned, this place is just about as good as it gets in the Wastes. The folks here are decent, and people look out for one another. Sure, some places might order more safety, but at the cost of personal freedom, no thank you. You came out of a caravan? Do they come here often? Not really. The Abbey's too small and isolated for the caravans to pay us much heed. Doesn't matter, though. We're a pretty self-sufficient community. Grow our own food, brew our own booze, so we get by just fine. Anyway, Bill's the man to speak to about caravans. He runs a general store just southwest of here. Okay. Just for there, I guess we'll have a new conversation option there. What else would you like to know? Do Do you know anything about a Garden of Eden creation, Kurt? Just want to see what he'll say. Sorry, pal, I've never heard of it, but if it has to do with pre-war times, I bet there's something about it in the monastery's computers. Unfortunately for you, those monks are real protective of their information, afraid that it'll lead to another war or something if people learn too much. Still, it might be worth asking around here. Alright. We've got a book or something in here. I'll grab that. I'm gonna go inside there, I think. Cat's paw. Alright. We can sell that. What was that? Oh, someone opened those shutters? Or not shades? Shades, curtains. I mean. There's a well. Which means there might be a downstairs. Tunnels. I'll have to try to remember. Okay, so we've got... The Abbey is rather big. Ooh, who's that? He looks spooky. Monastery Graveyard Keeper. Sounds like graveyard music. Oh, here's another person here. Bespectacled young monk. The young monk quickly pockets a deck of tragic cards as you approach. What do you want? I want to know why you just hid that card deck from me. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have any card deck. Don't lie to me. I saw you put it away in your pocket. I just want to know why. Look, don't tell anyone, alright? We're not supposed to use pre-war relics, just worship them. But these tragic cards are so damn cool. He seems to get lost in another world as he gazes lovingly at the deck. After a moment, he looks up at you. Oh, sorry. I'm Brother Jason, by the way. I don't suppose you play tragic? He used to be addicted as hell to that game. Yeah, why not? Hell yeah, I love tragic the garnering. Aw, man, I'd love to play against you, but it's too risky. I don't want these taken from me. That's what I hate about this place. We're sitting on a goddamn gold mine of awesome things from before the war, but we're forbidding ourselves from indulging in it. Doesn't make any sense. It's friggin' moronic. If you don't agree with the ideals of your order, then why are you a monk? You think I chose to be a monk? I was born into this shitty lifestyle. I just wish the others would wake up and see how stupid it is not to take advantage of all this sweet stuff we've collected. But no, they're perfectly content to worship and catalog the relics, but never actually do anything useful with them. Like I said, it's bleep moronic. I'll bet you about your life. If you think it's so stupid, then why don't you do something and try to change things? Actually, I do have an idea of how to change things. Maybe you can help me out. You see, the monks here have spent years transcribing pre-war information into our computer database. If someone were to accidentally format the database, they'd lose all that work. I think something like that might shock them back to their senses, and we might finally give up this stupid way of life. So, what do you say? Why don't you just format it yourself? You kidding me? They'd crucify me if I did that. You, however, you're an experienced adventurer. Hell, I bet you could massacre everyone here without breaking a sweat. So, will you do it, or are you afraid of just a bunch of pacifist monks? I'll test out your massacre theory starting with you. I'm not afraid of anyone. I'll do it. You will? Seriously? Aw, man, that's awesome. But first, you'll need to get access, because they're pretty protective of the database. Shouldn't be too hard, though. These monks are pretty trusting. They're gonna be pissed as hell when you format it, but they're all a bunch of wimps, so don't worry about it. Just try not to kill anyone. I don't want things to get too out of hand, you know. I'm betting this is gonna be more than we bargained for, and that this kid has no idea about this, how tough these guys might be. I make no promises, so anything else? Just format it, then take off, because they're not going to want you around here. Don't even bother to come tell me you did it, because I'll have to act just as pissed as everyone else, or they'll suspect something is up. Thanks again for doing this. It's for their own good. Whatever you say. Bye. I'm not sure if we're gonna do it, guys. I'll just look into this some more. I made him an offer to come to Gecko? You might want to reconsider my offer to take you to Gecko, because I know someone there that loves a good game of Tragic. No shit, another Tragic player? That kind of changes things. I wonder if he had a Black Dahlia to trade. Alright, I'll go if you escort me. Alright, but I need to take care of some things first. I'll let you know when I'm ready to go. Okay. So, we're really helping this guy out. This was assigned to control the flow of traffic. Not really. A whole lot of rust going on. Alright, let's see what we see in the status here. Format the Abbey's book database and escort Brother Jason to Gecko. Alright, we got some things to do. Interesting. And we got some more graves to read. The name and date on this headstone have been worn off by the weather. Except these don't say anything. All the cool descriptions are in Golgotha. You see a No. I don't want to do that. I just want to look at the graves, the headstones. John Doe. So this is a grave marker, but we've got... Did I take something? No, interesting. Graveyard Keeper. Hick! Hello there, my name's Samuel. What a hick brings you here? Yeah, we need to talk to him. I'm just looking around. Do you tend to this graveyard? Yes, hick! I tend to these here graves. Nobody else wants to hick do it, so old Sammy got the job. It's not as bad as one might think. It's got its perks, if you know what I mean. He grins sloppily and wiggles his bushy eyebrows at you. No, I don't know what you mean, but I'm morbidly curious. Nothing turns me on like a rotten cadaver. Well, I get to be outdoors and no one around to tell old Sammy when he's had enough. I know when I've had enough, when there's none left. He cackles, which quickly turns into a hideous cough. After coughing up a lung or two, he smiles at you. Okay, so it wasn't necrophilia. Of course that's what you meant. Sigh of relief. Let me ask you something else, though. What do you want to know? You the gravekeeper? Oh, okay. Oh, I don't have an option to tell him about that? I need to tell him about Father Tulley. What can you tell me about the Abbey? The Abbey? Well, this place, it's been my home for most of my life. Everyone here is nice and anyone's welcome as long as they don't cause trouble. You myself don't spend much time in the manor monastery, but I know our pewters have all kinds of info that's been gathered over the years. Maybe some of it might be of some use to you. You don't spend much time in the church? You are a monk, aren't you? He grins, revealing a gap-filled set of rotten teeth. Well, let's just say that the other monks don't take kindly to my drinking habits. Makes sense, I guess. Anything I can help you with? Let me think a minute. Yeah, I might got something if you're up to it. Sure, Sam, what do you need? Well, the past couple of days, I noticed some of these graves have been dug up. Now, whoever's doing this don't appear to be getting that far, but it's a pain for me to fill them back up. Well, did you try and figure out who has been doing this? Sure, I tried. One night I stayed around till midnight or so and no one showed up. Must have fallen asleep soon afterwards. Too much drinking, I suppose. He grins, pulls out his flask, and takes a hefty swig. So what do you say? You want to help out? Alright, I'll see what I can do. Do you have anything else that might help me? Well, now that you mention it, I do Remember Mr. Peterson saying something about hearing some noises coming from his field? He might know something about this. He and that pretty little wife of his live right over there. He points to the building south of the graveyard. I'll see what I can do. But I gotta tell him about... Get back here. No! Get back here. Do you know of Father Tulley? Father Tulley, you say? He appears to be racking his brain, trying to remember. Yeah, I remember Tully. How's that fella doing anyway? I ain't seen him since he was kicked out of here a long time ago. He grins drunkenly as he reflects. Boy, he was a hoot. Him and me together, what a combo. Well, he lives in New Reno, preaching near Good Word, something like that. You know, you two seem a lot alike. New Reno, huh? He leans on his shovel, pulls out a small flask, and takes a big swig. I remember him saying he been headed that way. I'm glad he made it there safely. I always liked that fella. A real hoot. If you see him again, tell him old Sammy is still alive and kicking. I'll do that. Alright. Surprised he has 88 points. Looks drunk and a bit drowsy. Alright, let's go talk to... Whoever the hell this guy's name is. Good to see you again. What can I do for you? Brother Samuel said you might know something about who is disturbing the graves. He said you heard some noises coming from your crops. Brother Samuel sent you here? What's that drunken up to now? Tending to the graves as usual, I suppose. So, about what you heard? John sits down in his chair and pulls himself a shot of whiskey. Okay. So you don't mind the hooch either. It all began a couple days ago. My wife and I were preparing for bed when we heard some rustling out there in the field. I grabbed my lantern and rushed outside to see if I could find the source of the noise. As soon as I made it to the fields, though, the noises had stopped. Go on. Well, the next night we didn't hear a thing, but the night after that we heard rustling coming from the field again. This time I crept to the window and looked out rather than rushing outside. Peering into the darkness, I saw a dim light, like from old lantern or something, moving among the crops. After a couple minutes, the light moved toward the cemetery. This story's getting too long. Go on. I wanted to go out and confront whoever or whatever it was, but the wife convinced me to stay inside and check on things in the morning. So in the next morning, I see some of my crops have been eaten, and there's fresh footprints all around. Now, I don't mind feeding the poor, but I don't take kindly to thieves. After that, I asked Brother Samuel if anything had happened in the graveyard. That's when he told me someone had begun digging up some of the graves. Apparently, whoever's doing this isn't strong enough to dig in one... to dig in one night. I guess it's an old beggar hoping to dig up some treasure. If you ever find out who's doing this, please tell him to stop by. There's no need for thievery here in the Abbey, and I'd be happy to help this person in any way I can. I'm just reading this. That was funny. I'll see what I can do. I'll try and catch this individual. Maybe I'll wait around midnight and see if I can find anything out. Well, thanks for the information. Take care. What time is it? I thought it was... The Goris was the one. Oh, it's 6 in the morning. Let's look around first. It's around the outside. I've got this... Is this part of the Abbey here? Or is there a separate building? It's like a separate building. Oh, we've got some people outside we can talk to. Newspaper machine. Looks like it once held adult magazines. Hi, how can I help you? What can you tell me about your order? Our holy mission is to collect and preserve the sacred relics of the forgotten past. Anyone is welcome here as long as they don't damage anything. What kind of relics? All sorts, but most of our memorabilia consists of ancient tomes. So much information can be obtained from these texts. It is our mission to preserve this knowledge so that a future generation may use it to build a new world of peace and joy. Who is your leader? He can be found on the third floor. If you wish to learn more about our order, he is the one to talk to. Okay. Let's barter. Let's barter. Oh, wow. Oh, he's got a 9mm Mauser, huh? And, a zip gun? Okay. It only takes one shot at a time. It's not that expensive. Curious about it. Zip gun. Why not? Maybe it has some specialized purpose. Possibly. Zip gun. Other than that, nothing I'm interested in. A handmade single-shot pistol. Interesting. Damage 5 to 12. It might be a specialty item. Maybe someone's looking for it? I don't know. I'm just gonna talk to these people outside. Functional lamppost. A holy woman. Tough guard. Let's talk to the guard. Hi there, traveler. Welcome to the Abbey. Keep your nose clean and we'll get along just fine. Who are you? Nobody. Just an old retired caravan guard. A lot of people mistake me for some sort of sheriff because I'm the closest thing resembling the law in these parts. But I'm not. I just look out for this community because I think it's worth protecting. In return, the community looks out for me. I get some complimentary booze from the monks, Peterson makes sure I'm fed, and Bill makes sure I've got ammo and stims. Not a bad retirement gig, if you ask me. That is a nice arrangement. Let me ask you something else. What else do you want to know? Somebody is digging up graves. Why don't you do anything about it? If someone is poor and greedy enough to try and dig up graves, that's their business. It's not like the dead can use what they're buried with anyway. Not my problem. I'm not losing any sleep over it. That's an interesting perspective on that. Where can I barter for some supplies? You can find Bill, our resident trader, in the building across from here. Other than that, you ought to go to Percy's survival gear locker at the junkyard in Gecko. I've been there. Or Happy Harry's in the courtyard at Vault City. Been there. Actually, I should just pay another visit to Percy's. He will not barter. Alright. Holy woman. Nice weather. Another holy woman? Life here at the Abbey is a peaceful one. Something rare in these wretched wastes. In this game has been jammed shut and the bars look very sturdy. This house looks like separate from the Abbey. That newspaper machine is empty. Oh. Box is empty. You get the feeling it's been that way for a while. I guess there's nothing in there. Okay, there's really nothing of interest in here. So it looks glaring. Stubborn little son of a bitch. Someone's struggling with something. The sun is coming up before our eyes. Pretty interesting. One hell of a wedgie. Let's take a look in here. Oh, you can just run in. Lower the ground for those really short mutants. Keep your city streets clean. Well, you'd think I'd fix this place up. Okay. So obviously something's coming up through this well. Something is coming up through the well. Going through the field, I guess, in order to sneak and get to these graves. Junk. Okay. So stay tuned for next episode when we actually go inside the Abbey and out of this nice weather. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.